I worked on Angular for a long time. Actually, I remember when I first started, my first child was on its way. And so it was about a half a year before he was born. And I remember saying, I need to quickly finish this so that it's done before he's born. Turns out software doesn't work that way, right? Like software is something you keep on working on for a long time. And so my oldest kid is now 12. So that means I've been working on Angular for about 13 years. 13 years is a super, super long time. And after 13 years, you want to try new things. And so about 3 years ago at ngConf, I gave a keynote, and in the keynote, I was talking about like, how could we build applications different, right? If you go back in time, like I think AngularJS kind of revolutionized the way we build web applications, right? Because before that, we had things like jQuery, which was in itself pretty amazing, but it didn't really give a cohesive way for applications to be built, right? AngularJS kind of started that. And there was lots of derivative frameworks, right? React being the most popular, Vue, Svelte, and so on and so forth, right? All of these basically are taking the same idea of AngularJS and kind of improving DX or tooling or sort of things of that sort, right? And so after 12 years of working on something, I wanted to try something new. There was a big question of whether I should build anything, right? Or maybe I should just do something else. And I've definitely had many months of like going back and forth. And in the end, I kind of realized that the world needs a kind of a new framework that really is about the performance, right? Because we have done a wonderful job improving on the developer experience. But if you look at existing state of the world, fast websites are kind of hard to find. And when you kind of dig into it, you realize that the problem is always the same. There's just too much JavaScript executed on the startup of the application. And so the focus for me became like, how could I lower the amount of JavaScript? Like what kind of tricks we can do, right? And so Partytown is one answer and Qwik is the other answer. And I really wanted to make sure that whenever I'm going to work on something, I'm not competing on the same set of things like the rest of the frameworks. I don't want to compete on DX. Like, there's already lots of choices out there, and having a yet another choice in developer experience would be nice, but it's not really game-changing, right? And so I wanted to make sure that if I work on something, it is going to be kind of game-changing, right? And so the thing that Qwik focuses on is extreme fine-grained lazy loading, right? How do I make sure that I don't have to download any JavaScript to get the website up and running, right? And this is in a stark contrast into existing websites where like the amount of JavaScript to get the site going is insane. And that actually results in really bad performance in terms of like, especially on mobile devices, it's not unheard of for a website to take 30 seconds to come up before it's interactive, right? And so the question for me was, how can we get even on a slow mobile device, how can we get a site up and running? And so this is kind of why after 13 years of working on Angular, I kind of realized that Angular is just too big. Like it's not really possible to move big pieces of it around because any such big movement would create a breaking change for the customers, right? And most of these customers are in a state of mind where like they need to make sure that they can deliver things rather than doing big, huge rewrites or anything of that sort. And so this is kind of where I kind of decided that like, you know what? I think Angular is in its teenage years, it's all grown up, it's time for it to kind of move out of the house, right? And I don't need to really be there for it. And so I started exploring different opportunities, and the opportunity with Builder came out where there was a good mixture of what Builder does as a company, focuses on e-commerce websites. But at the same time, we can provide open source solution to make these e-commerce websites faster, right? So it's a good combination of altruistic open source software that I can share. And at the same time, there are real companies which are willing to pay real money to kind of help to solve their problem. And so that's where I ended up.